Jay Shivani?
Yes, sir.
This is your first attempt?
No, sir, second.
Second?
Yes, sir.
And interview also?
Yes, sir, second.
Second. So last time you appeared in interview?
Yes, sir, I appeared in interview.
Did you get into any job last time?
No, sir, I was not recommended.
Okay. You are from Bhopal?
Yes, sir.
Tell me the importance of Bhopal. Three, four sentences.
Sir, importance of Bhopal can be seen in various domains. First of all, is the strategic location it has in the country, which is the centermost point, so that it is very good for connectivity to other places and also transportation and travelling. Other is, it is one of the most cleanest city, ranked second in the Swachhata Survekshan last year. So it is also important as a model city for other cities to do the things for cleanliness and improvement in the urban waste management thing. And it is also very good for tourism. It has various lakes in it. It is a city of lakes, and so it is a very good tourist destination also.
How is this new Bhopal more attractive than the old Bhopal?
Sir, newer Bhopal is the place where more major developments are taking place in Bhopal. Mainly the Hoshangabad Road where I stay, the National Highway 12. All the major malls and all the major businesses are shifting to that place because it is very, very developing very at a very fast pace, and it has a very prime location too.
It's a lovely lake.
Yes.
That is the biggest attraction.
Yes, sir.
Okay. You have mentioned in your extracurricular activities that you will execute these entrepreneurial ideas for problem solving.
Yes.
I give you a specific problem. Suppose you are appointed as district magistrate in a tribal dominated area in Odisha or Chhattisgarh. You know the problems.
Yes.
This is tribal dominated. How you will solve this district as district magistrate and solve the problems using your entrepreneurial ideas?
Sir, the tribal areas of, let's say, Orissa or Chhattisgarh have a problem of tribal people having a discontent with the state and not being happy with the development mainly. So, and also there is a lack of development there, and also lack of education.
There are some big problem, internal security problem.
Yes, sir.
What is that?
Sir, Naxalism.
Left-wing extremism.
Yes, sir. Sir, for solving these problems, I would firstly focus on education, and incorporating entrepreneurial ideas into education can be improving rural education using innovative ideas to teach, and also using technology for development of the education at a very fast pace.
You see, they are not allowing, the Naxals are not allowing the school building to be constructed. They are demolishing the buildings. So, what about technology to be used in? Tell me something else.
Sir, technology can, sir, this is a very long term thing. The focusing on education, it is a very long term measure.
Long term thing, and lots of you will
yes,
be at best for 2 years.
Yes, sir. As the immediate measure, we'll focus on first of all security aspect, and incorporating innovative ideas into solving the security problems can be using various technologies for detecting whatever the activities are going on, and also taking strict measures against those in an immediate term, and then focusing on the long term measure.
Our constitution has been has managed to effectively and smoothly carry forward our democracy for say 70 years now. What do you think are the reasons for this?
Sir, our constitution is a very detailed constitution, and one of the biggest constitution in the world. It has various provisions regarding almost everything that can come, and also the concept of separation of power that has been incorporated into our constitution provides a very good checks and balances system between all the organs of the government, which is a very good provision which has enabled us to function very effectively after independence.
Okay. It's a living document.
Yes, sir.
It's flexible.
Yes, sir.
And we have borrowed it from the experience of other
yes.
countries. Now, directive principles of state policy, they are relevant even today.
Yes.
Can you justify this statement?
Sir, directive principles of state policy are like a guiding light for the policies that are to be made by the government, by the state government and by the central government. It incorporates various social and economic rights which are not there in the fundamental rights. Fundamental rights mainly focus on the political rights and social and economic.
They are relevant even today.
Yes.
How do you justify this?
Sir, there are various provisions in the directive principles of state policy which involves modernization of industries, promotion of cottage industries, village level industries.
Most of the schemes of the government today, even today, are basically implementing those. Can you list some of the schemes?
Sir, the recent one in the budget of providing basic income, taking an initiative towards the concept of the basic income, is coming from that economic rights only, providing equal opportunities to all, and also trying to create a kind of equality in the state development level, on the status level of all the sections of the society.
Why do we need all India services?
Sir, all India services are mainly needed for the basic concept of national integration and enabling centrally recruited officials to serve in various areas of the country, so that various good concepts of one region can be implemented in the other region as well, and overall integration is able to be
occurred. Okay, can you tell us how, what is the legal provision which is there to keep away people with convicted people away from electoral politics?
So there are various provisions under Representation of the People's Act, which one of them which I remember right now is the barring the convicted person from participating in the elections after the release. Like if he is convicted for at least 2 years, then 6 years after the release he or she cannot participate in the elections.
There was an exception to this.
Yes.
Which was struck down in Lily Thomas.
Yes.
What was that exception?
So the exception was that if a person is convicted and if he or she appeals to the higher court, then at the duration of that appeal he or she was able to participate.
The exception was only for sitting legislators, not for everybody, and it was called on the ground of 14. Now, can you tell us, recently there was another petition in the Supreme Court to make the provision more stringent. What was it?
Sir, as far as I remember, it was for the complete ban of the convicted persons from participating
even
in the electoral
facing those facing charges. That was dismissed. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Mathematics and National Science. Where are the Institute of Mathematics located in India? How many are there? How many Institute of Mathematics are there in India?
So there is one major institution of mathematical sciences in Chennai, and then there are various statistical institutes which relates to mathematics. One is in Kolkata, Indian Statistical Institute in Kolkata.
I'm not asking about statistics, mathematics.
And sir, I'm not aware about the only mathematics specific institutes, but there are applied mathematics subjects in various IITs also. They are providing various applied mathematics subjects, and also in the Delhi University, a mathematics subject is provided by various colleges.
There is an Institute of Mathematics besides Chennai, also in Bhubaneswar, in Odisha. This is under the state government, that is under the central government. Now tell me, if you have to do encourage fundamental research in mathematics, physics, which is the right place for that?
Sir, I think the institutes, the higher education institute should focus upon tilt towards the research domain, apart from the rote learning or from focusing on placements only. And for this, academy and industrial linkage is very important. So I think the start has to be from the linkage of the academy.
My question is, today which is the place where one can do fundamental research in mathematics? Besides the Institute of Mathematics, which are in Bhubaneswar and Chennai, which other IIT is one place, correct? Any other place?
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware.
You have heard about IJERS?
Yes, sir.
IJERS, they also have independent research team in that. Now, Cyber Olympiad is one scholarship you have got.
Yes, sir.
So, is the cyber crime increasing globally or decreasing or constant?
Sir, with various advancements in technology, it is increasing globally, and it has to, various steps are being taken to tackle it, but yet much has not been achieved, and it, and various governments are working in this domain.
What is malware?
Malware is an can be an application installed into a computer which provides a backdoor entry or which blocks the access of the user of its content.
It is very common now.
Yes, sir. It has started to become common. It has started to become very common, and for this only various companies, various IT companies are taking initiatives to tackle this, and they are involving various patches into their software so that they can protect it from malware.
Okay. Now in India, which is the agency which is in charge of cyber security?
Sir, there is Computer Emergency Response Team, which oversees all the cyber crimes that are potential cyber crimes and also the already occurred cyber crimes, and to tackle that it takes initiatives and it, then it guides various other agencies to take the step.
Do we have a cyber security policy?
Yes, sir.
When was it completed?
Sir, 2013.
And globally?
Sir, globally there is a Budapest Convention for cyber crimes. Which is which also has a xenophobic treaty under it, and there is also GDPR of the Europe Global Data Protection Regulations, which protect which are related to the protection of the data in the cyber domain.
Recently, RBI has given a direction about data localization. What is that? Can you just say something about that?
Sir, data localization, the guidelines given are that the critical data, which is critical information data, which is important for the national security and for public order, it has to be localized, and it cannot be stored in the global servers, and it has to be processed and collected locally at local servers only.
Now, storing the data in India, MasterCard or Visa, they have their data in Singapore.
Yes, sir.
They have to store it in India. That is the issue.
Yes, sir.
Do you agree it should be done? They don't agree.
Sir, I think for data protection, even in the draft data protection bill, it was envisaged that critical data should be stored locally, and I agree to that to an extent, because critical data has to be processed locally only, and also it helps in faster investigation of the cyber crimes if they occur, because if the data is stored abroad in various other servers globally, then acquiring of that data will take a lot of time and delays will be there. So investigation will also faster now because of that.
The last question, tell me, what are the three major items of import and export from India?
Sir, major items of import include crude oil, the biggest.
One is crude then.
Second is... Second is, sorry sir, I'm not.
Export.
Exports, we have software exports. We have a lot of software exports from our country. Also, we have agricultural exports are also there. And also, we also export the refined oil. Sorry sir, I'm not aware of the exact.
Mr. Jay Shivani.
Yes sir.
Have we come out of the disaster that Bhopal had to go through last century?
Sir, a substantial progress has been made, but yet there are some issues. There are some genetic diseases that have occurred and that have creeped in people.
Have
and
we created any institutional mechanism to ensure that this kind of thing don't recur? Is there any institutional mechanism created both at the India level and also for the states?
Sorry, I'm not aware about this.
NDMA?
Yes.
Disaster Management Authority?
Yes, sir.
What is its role? Can you have some idea about how they are supposed to operate?
Sir, National Disaster Management Authority mainly first of all provides the guidelines for various disasters, what has to be done in for prevention, mitigation, and also for building back better. Apart from it, when it occurs, there is a National Disaster Response Force under it, which reacts and which responses towards the disaster that has occurred, and also there is a National Disaster Response Fund,
right,
which is for funding the...
You have heard of the concept DBT?
Yes, sir.
What is that concept? And in the budget also, I think there is a mention of DBT.
Yes.
briefly explain what it is?
DBT refers to direct benefits transfer, which means directly transferring of the subsidies or directly transferring of the benefits to the accounts of the beneficiaries so that the intermediaries are eliminated and leakages are plugged.
Right. In respect of which commodities or which items the DBT has been tried?
Sir, it has been tried very successfully in LPG subsidy, Pahel, under Pahel scheme. And also recently in the budget, in PM Kisan Yojana, they have talked about the directly transferring the minimum income of around 6,000 towards the account of vulnerable and the marginal farmers.
Has it been tried in respect of fertilizer subsidy?
Yes, sir.
It has been tried.
Yes, sir.
It is still.
It has been tried on a pilot basis.
Pilot basis, it has.
In some states.
Now I think they are able to implement that.
Yes, sir.
Okay, universal basic income.
Yes, sir.
What is this concept?
Sir, universal basic income was the concept that was referred in the economic survey last year, which means to transfer a basic income, minimum basic income, towards the account of all the people universally, so that they are able to fulfill their basic amenities and the subsidies are also rationalized. That
it is a false hope, something which is possible and plausible.
Sir, it is desirable. But given the fiscal constraints that will occur and also the social constraints, social impacts that might occur because of that, negative impacts can also occur. So it is not feasible yet, but targeted basic income can be focused.
Apart from finance, what could be the other problem in implementing this?
Sir, first of all, financial inclusion has to be there for all the people. One is this. Other is there can be various social constraints because where the people will spend the money, it can be in the negative field also.
Even identification of the beneficiary itself will be a huge task.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
Okay. Can you mention some of the internal security concerns?
Sir, internal security concerns. The first one is the left-wing extremism. Other is insurgency and militants in the border areas, including Jammu and Kashmir, and also in some areas in the northeast, and also there is a recent concept of urban nationalism also cropping up.
Economic crimes.
Yes, sir.
Will you put that also in this category?
Sir, I don't think it majorly comes under the security domain, but it can add in some cases.
Coming to the left-wing extremism, why it is that it is persisting even though about 40-50 years have passed since the problems are faced?
Sir, there is discontent among some sections of the people because of the development deficits and also lack of opportunities in employment and education, which is to be focused upon. And also as an immediate step, security has to be beefed up and inclusiveness has to be implemented.
Last question.
Yes, sir.
Venezuela, what is happening and why is it a matter of concern for India?
Sir, Venezuela is undergoing a political crisis and it has come on the back of a an economic crisis that has been going on in Venezuela. The inflation is around 10 million% there. So there is an interim president. He has declared one, Mr. Juan Guaido, has declared himself interim president, and also he has been supported by various countries, which includes USA and Europe.
Why is it a matter of concern for India?
So it is a matter of concern from India because we import oil from Venezuela and political stability is important.
How much of oil we import from Venezuela? Any idea? What percentage is
that?
It's a major source of oil.
Yes,
Jay, why do you want to join civil services?
Sir, civil services provides me a very wider domain and also a very wider canvas to work upon in the public services domain, which I am attracted to, and also it is a very good career option.
We come to an end of your mock interview.
Thank you, sir.
We'll give you a small feedback.
Yes, sir. Okay.
How do you think you are fair?
Okay, not very good, but okay.
You are doing quite well.
Thank you, sir.
But 2-3
Sir, can I write?
Yeah, please. Some feedbacks will be.
Yes, yes.
You see, there will be number of questions which will be asked.
Yes, sir.
You do not have much time for each question to answer. There is not enough time. So, whatever answer you give, in 3-4 sentences. Like Bhopal is something I asked.
Yes.
Bhopal, importance of Bhopal. So you should be able to say within that 2 minutes primer for the 4-5 sentences.
Yes.
Total population, its literacy percentage, and anything. It's a tourist important which you mentioned, that is noteworthy. And what are the tourist sites, so that it attracts the population? And how, you know, because nowadays that is just, you know, MP tourism's that slogan,
yes,
soul
sir.
Of India.
Yes, sir.
Heart of India. So, that is number one.
Yes.
Number two, like this institutional mechanism, there was a question asked, Bhopal tragedy and all that. You know, you should not wait too long, only after prodding you could make that answer. These are very important questions.
Yes.
For which anybody, because you know, for your prelims, for your main, you know, you have been preparing and you know.
Yes.
And NDMA is a, you know, national disaster management is a very important subject.
So it
should know this, you know, it should be so that you should be able to answer these questions without any
remiss.
It should come.
Yes,
so prepare some 70-80-100 questions which are of topical importance. Like, you know, in GS also you have studied them, like NDMA. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Role of NHRC. CAG, Women Commission.
Yes.
But you know, these they can ask any such questions. Okay. So that you will be able to answer them.
Yes. Sir.
And then you know, you have mentioned in your hobbies and extracurricular activities, executing entrepreneurial ideas for problem solving.
Yes, sir.
So thinking and executing. So you have given more emphasis, and then computer coding. So there would be answer, because most of the questions will be asked based on that.
Yes, yes.
So accordingly we asked a question that suppose you are posted in a tribal dominated areas in Chhattisgarh and Odisha, it was pointed also. So instead of saying education, spread of education, then technology, use of technology, you see, what is the question of education? They are not getting the basic minimum. PDS is not reaching. Roads are not there.
Yes, sir.
You know, people. So, you see, first of all, you said that the main problem these areas have, tribal dominated areas, they are elderly.
Yes, sir.
So, you know, use of technology in knowing their activities. Nowadays, our police force, they have been equipped with this thing, but even then, they are not using this technology properly. They should be able to locate them.
Yeah.
You see, maintaining law and order and the stability of that area is the first priority.
Yes, sir.
Second thing, all the important government schemes, they are not getting implemented, they are not getting their PDS.
Yes, sir.
They are not getting their education because the entire teachers and everybody has left that place. So these are the things, how you will use your technology, your e-governance system to get the information, to utilize them for those purposes, you should be able to answer.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Otherwise, you are doing very well. Current affairs, you should be able to answer, because there are lot of things which are happening. Are you reading newspaper regularly?
Yes.
Okay. So, also read a paper on this economic, all this budget, this thing. Like one, like Hindu or Times of India, you must be reading.
Yes.
Then the other one must be some Economic Times or this Financial Times, something like that. Okay. So that you get a good grasp of the current affairs.
Yes.
And you should be able to answer those questions. There will be surely, out of the all questions, about 10-15 questions on current affairs.
Yes, sir.
And you know what are the, like, what is the update of Lokpal. So like that. There
yes,
is,
sir.
So, we have not been able to ask many questions because of paucity of time. But on current affairs, there will be some questions. Okay?
Yes.
And you should be able to answer it to the best of your ability and satisfaction.
Yes.
That will fetch you good marks.
Yes. Sir.
Okay? Otherwise, you are doing very well. You are looking confident. Your personality is very good. So, we hope you will do very well.
Thank you, sir.
Okay?
Thank
all
you.
All the best.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.